Structured references lets you use table names along with column names in formulas rather than cell references. Structured references can be used both inside and outside of a table. Let's first look at using a formula in data that is not a table. Then we will look at creating the same formula in a table. The data in columns A through D is not a table. I will enter the formula for the balance in cell D2. I will start the formula with an equal sign. I will click on cell B2. The cell reference B2 is now part of my formula. I will type a minus sign and then click on cell C2. The cell reference C2 is now part of my formula. I will press Ctrl plus Enter. I will drag the autofill handle down through the column. When I click on the cells in the balance column, you can see that, because I used relative addressing, the formulas were automatically adjusted for the change in row. Now, let's look at the same data, but in a table format. I will click in the first cell in the balance column. I will click on Table Design on the menu bar. The table is currently named Table 1. I will change it to something more meaningful. I will name it Sales 2021. I will enter a formula for the balance in cell I2. I will type the equal sign and then click in cell G2. Because this is a table, the formula is not showing the cell address. Rather, it is using the column heading. I will enter the minus sign and then click on cell H2. Again, the column heading was placed in the formula rather than the cell address. I will press the Enter key. I didn't need to use the autofill handle to copy the formulas down through the column. It was done automatically for me. I can use the table structure outside of the table. I will compute the table balance outside of the table. In cell K2, I will enter the equal sign, and then I will type the first letter of the table. Excel's IntelliSense has brought up the options that start with S. I can easily see that Sales 2021 is a table because of the table icon in front of it. I will double-click on it to accept it. You can see that the entire Sales 2021 table is now selected. I don't want to use the entire table. I only want to recompute the balance. I will type a left square bracket. The four column names as well as other options appear. I will double-click on Invoice Totals. I will type a closing right bracket. I will type a minus sign. I will type an S again and then double-click on Sales 2021. I will type a left bracket. I will double-click on Payments. I will type a closing right bracket. I will press Enter. The formulas were copied down the column. Let's look at some more of the available options for structured references. The table starting in cell A1 is named Sales 2022. The table starting in cell A12 is named Sales 2023. I want to add the invoice totals for each ID from the Sales 2022 and Sales 2023 tables. I will type the equal sign and then the starting letters for Sales 2022, SA. I will double-click on the Sales 2022 table. I will type the left bracket to get the options for the Sales 2022 table. I will double-click on the invoice totals. I will type the closing right bracket and then a plus sign. I will type SA. I will double-click on the Sales 2023 table. I will type the left bracket and select Invoice Totals. I will type the right closing bracket and then press Enter. You can see that Excel added the 14,000 invoice total in the Sales 2022 table to the 19,997 Sales 2023 table, giving the result 33,997. The formula was copied down through the column. Next, I will use a structured reference to duplicate the entire Sales 2022 table data, including the headings. In cell F1, I will enter an equal sign and then SA. I will double-click on Sales 2022. I will enter a left bracket and then select the All option. I will type the right closing bracket and then press Enter. This is not a table. It just copied the data, including headings, from the table. Removing the copied table is simple. Delete the formula in the first cell of the copied data. Next, I just want to copy the data without any headings. I will enter the equal sign, then type SA and select Sales 2022. I will enter the left bracket and then select Data. And then type the right closing bracket. I will press Enter. Only the table data was copied. I will press Ctrl plus Z to undo. Next, I will copy the headings without any of the data. I will enter the equal sign, then type SA and select Sales 2022. I will enter the left bracket and then select Headers, and then type the right closing bracket. I will press Enter. Only the table headers were copied. I will press Ctrl plus Z to undo. Next, I want to copy a row of data from the Sales 2022 table. I will click in a cell that is in the same row I want to copy. After selecting Sales 2022 and entering the left bracket, I will select this row. Excel uses the at sign to represent the current row. I will press Enter. All of the data from the current row is copied. What if you only want one cell value from the current row? After selecting Sales 2022, and entering the left bracket, I will select this row. I will enter a left bracket and then select the column name of the cell I want to copy. I will type two right closing brackets and then press Enter. I will add a total row to the Sales 2023 table. I will click anywhere in the table to make it active. On the menu bar, I will click on Table Design. In the Table Style Options group, I will check Total Row. I want to copy the total row from the Sales 2023 table. After selecting Sales 2023 and entering the left bracket, I will select Totals. I will type the right closing bracket and then press Enter. I want to copy the balance from the total row. I will type the equal sign and select sales 2023. Since the active cell is not in the same row, I can't use the this row option. When you want to get a particular cell value and your active cell is not in the same row, you will need to type two left brackets. I will select the totals and type a right bracket. To get to the next option, I will need to type a comma and then a left bracket. Now I can select balance, type two closing right brackets, and press enter. Let's say that I want to copy just the data in the payments column. How would I do that? You have already learned how to get just the data from a table. After selecting the table, you will need to type two left brackets and then select data. You will then need to type the closing right bracket, a comma, and a left bracket. You can now select the column whose data you want. Type the two closing right brackets and press enter.